Hey guys, so I have a lot of respect for a lot of different professions. You know, I really respect taxi cab drivers, those people who sweep the street, sanitation workers, sewage workers, dirty jobs, really, you know. I have a huge amount of respect for the people who do those kind of jobs, I just can't imagine doing the jobs myself, and it's amazing to me. You know, they provide so much amazing benefit to society, and most of us don't even realize it. You know, we just take it so granted that those people work, get paid their wage, and you know that's how we live. But I really do think one of the currently my part-time job, I am a classroom tutor in elementary school. And to me, it's a really fun job. I just get to hang out in the classroom. I work under a teacher with the teacher. When the students are not there, I just kind of assist the teacher. You know, help with the lesson plan, help organize the room, set up things, prepare things for the next class to teach, things of that nature. I just help with the teacher. And when the students are in the classroom and they're doing activity, you know, when the teacher is giving the lesson plan, I sit with the students, or I'm in the corner, you know, preparing something else for the student, for the teacher, helping the teacher out. And then when the students get into their activity and they start doing things, I'm moving around, I'm talking with the students, and I'm helping them learn if they have any difficulties or any questions. You know, that's pretty much what I do. I'm just like an extra help to the teacher in a science classroom, and I meet with kindergartners, that's another topic actually. Kindergartners is a different topic altogether. I'll probably make another video on that. There's also pre-kindergartners. I have first graders, fourth graders, third graders, and fifth graders that I work with. There's no second graders that I work with, which is interesting. But I'm in a science classroom, and different grade levels change classes all the time. It's a really interesting, weird system. Like, I'm trying to think of my experience as an elementary school student. I've never had that. You know, most of my education is from California. And as a third grade student in California, look, I got one teacher, one classroom, that was it. That was my classroom for the whole school day. On some occasions, the teacher did take us to a different classroom, maybe for a math section or something, but for the most part, almost every day, you know, I was under, you know, I was in the students with, under the same teacher, with the same group of kids, all day, every day. So this is, it's a really different kind of system, this New York City, Brooklyn public school system where kids are switching classes, even though they're kindergartners. Just craziness. Anyway, that aside, I really got to hand it to the teacher. When I was starting to kind of formulate what I want to do when I grow up, like, teaching was kind of one of them. But seeing teaching now, like, firsthand, like, what a teacher has to go through every day, it must be such a tough thing, because if it's just teaching, I think that would be a fun thing. You know, just tutoring, that's all I'm doing. I'm just interacting with the kids, preparing the stuff a little bit, and then helping the kids learn. That's fun. That's really fun. Teaching is, to me, at least, I relate to that. I relate to the passion of teaching. It's fun. And I love seeing kids grapple with materials and learn, and seeing their kind of, you know, they all kind of have a way of demonstrating the thought process. Seeing that, amazing. I love it. In that way, I think I was born to be a teacher. I would love to be a teacher. But it's so much more than just teaching. You know, there's all this paperwork. They have to prepare all this lesson plan with limited amount of supply. And there's always a struggle for supply. It's like, especially in schools I've been to where they're really underfunded. A lot of the public schools that I've been to, I haven't really been to that many, but a lot of them are just struggling with students in poverty. You know, they're in lower income neighborhoods. So it's always a struggle for supplies. It's insane. One of the examples that I'll bring up in my experience as a classroom tutor is, like, there's no glue sticks. Like, teachers have to, like, call each other on the phones, like, I need two glue sticks. I'm going to send the, you know, the student tutor over to you. Like, you have glue sticks. I have three. And but that's, like, you have to give them back to me after your tutor uses it. And I go there and I use it and I bring it back. It's just insane. It's just glue sticks, man. And you need a lot of glue sticks, but three glue sticks to cover hundreds of students? It's insane. You know, to have to deal with this, like, supply stuff. Your kids are always jumping in and out, and you're preparing lesson plans in between. There's all these paperwork that you gotta finish up. Even after your students leave, you gotta prepare for the next day, for each class, for each grade. It's amazing, I think, the amount of work that a teacher has to do. In an ideal world, in my ideal world, it would be amazing for a teacher to be able to teach by also having, like, a teacher's assistant. That we have to kind of go through these hoops. So I'm an American Reads student classroom tutor, right? So they're using a federally funded nonprofit agency for a teacher to have an assistant 2 days a week. What kind of system is that? Wouldn't, like, it would be so amazing if there was teacher who just focused on teaching, you know, 5 days a week, who also had a full-time or maybe multiple part-time teacher assistants, who just assisted in all the other things, you know, helping to tutor or helping to provide materials to kids, helping to prepare lesson plans. Ideal world. I don't know. It would be amazing. It would be amazing if schools were better funded than the way it is. I know the big thing, the big trend now is the privatization of education in America. Charter schools, it's becoming a big thing, which scares me, scares the shit out of me. And there's going to be an election pretty soon in New York City, actually. November 5th is election day. Depending on who becomes a mayor, it's going to change education of New York quite a bit. One of the candidates believes strongly in the growth of charter schools. Terrifies the shit out of me. I've seen what... I haven't actually, like, been to a charter school. Yes. So, but anyway, like, my experience with charter schools is not, like, super... Whatever, it's not, a founded experience like I have with public schools. But just observing, like, my internship is at a high school. It's a high school in Brooklyn, New York. One of the interesting thing about it is that it's this one building, right? In this one building, there's five high schools. One of the high schools is the high school that I'm an intern in. Four other high schools are in there also. The same building. Two of those high schools are charter schools. What I've seen from being in the same building with those charter schools. The students, the staff, the school in general, like, the how it functions, it's a nightmare. Like, it's ridiculous. I can't believe how awful it is. It's insane. And, like, it seems to me that the staff cares more about, like, the public image. So one good example is inside the school, you'll see these charter school students kind of wandering about with no supervision whatsoever inside the school. It's crazy. It's a nightmare. There's fights about to break out all the time. People are loud. There's no supervision. But when their school hour ends and the kids are going back home, you'll see the staff walking with them to the bus stop. And, like, it seems great. They have supervision outside of the school. Why? Public image plays a big part with charter schools. Because charter schools are like for-profit businesses. That matters to them more than education of students. In some ways, not true, not to discredit people who work in charter schools, because I know that's a challenge too, and charter schools do great work. I have no doubt about that, but it's just, that is not a way to fix the education system, I think. You know, anyway, my focus on this video is really that teachers are to be commended for. There's just so much a teacher has to deal with, more than just teaching, and I think that's an incredible thing, and they do it. It's It's kind of like me wanting to be a social worker. You know, when someone determines that their passion is to be a teacher, I don't think it really is about money. You know, teacher salary, it's not that great. Social worker salary, in most cases, not always necessarily, it's not that great. We go into this line of work because we want to, because we have a passion for it. And I think teachers, in a lot of ways, do have a passion for it. There's a lot of kind of problematic things that I noticed with teachers. That's probably a topic for future videos. But for the most part, like the job itself, you know, I respect it. Much respect given to the teaching profession.